Hi, my name is Brian English, Rappler Forum name Hyperbytes, and in this module I'm going to show you how to create an initial project. And this is the project we'll be using throughout this course. So we're still in our virtual environment that I created earlier, and you can see we've continued exactly where we left off in the module about installing Rappler. So the first thing we're going to do is to create a new project. We can do that in one of two ways. We can either go up to the top of the screen here and use the plus sign here, or we can use the project manager, which is just down on the bottom left hand corner here. And I'll use a project manager that opens up a modal, and you can see there's some options along the top here to show folders. That is the same as the new project up here. You have the opportunity to open a project from an existing folder. So let's say you've moved a project from one folder to another, or even moved it from machine to next. You can just copy that folder over and reopen it, and it will set up Rappler exactly how it was set up on the other machine. We also have the ability to be able to clone a project from a Git repository, and then just some basic sorts there. So we actually need a new project, so we can either click the plus or click new project here. And then we'll just click blank. Now, our project is going to be called Community Web, and I'll just select a folder to place that. Obviously, I'm in my virtual environment at the minute, so this project location will change later on. But for the purposes of this, that's fairly irrelevant. So we select that folder. It's going to be a Rappler local server, and we're going to be serving model node.js. So we can simply save that. Rappler will then open some initial files. If you see now, it's created a layout page, and there should also be a content page there. They open by a standard, so your layout is main and your initial page of index, and because Node is a rooted system, it's also created a root for that as well. So the root of the website will open that index page, and you can of course edit that if you wish, and we'll come to that at a later stage. For the moment, we're more concerned with our project, so I'm going to now hit project settings. We'll use the pencil icon up at the top on this occasion, albeit we could also have done this from project settings. Just get rid of thank you Rappler. I think we get the message. So if we work through our settings here, we're using Bootstrap 5. By default, Rappler has created a CSS file in a CSS folder within the web root, which is the public directory. It's also created an assets folder, which you would effectively be able to keep your images and videos, etc. in. Your links will be relative to the site root. User uploads folder will be blank. Now, we need to explain what user uploads folder is. Imagine you are running this project, as you will be, primarily in a development environment. And within that, you have some actions where you will be uploading images to your server, or perhaps even videos. And you'll be using dummy data, test data, just to check the functionality of your website. Then when you deploy your website to your production machine, your public website, you probably don't want those images, that test data, to be uploaded to your production server, because that was just test data. So what we can do is we can define a folder, and all files within that folder and its subfolders will not be uploaded to your production server when we deploy our system to our production server. Now I'm going to do that. We're going to click on the user uploads folder. I'm going to place that in the public directory, because that's where we would need to put it, basically. I'm going to create a new folder, and I'm simply going to call it uploads. So there we have an area where we can place files for testing purposes that will not be replicated to our production server. Wappler has added the basic frameworks that it needs, FontAwesome 5, Bootstrap 5, and the all-important App Connect. And if we go into targets now, we can see that we have our development environment on a local web server, designated development. That's quite important because there's certain functions you can only do, particularly with database, when you're in a development target. We say our web server, we know that's working. We can do a quick test connection if we want. But you see at this stage, we still do not have a database set up. So if we select SQLite, but we actually need to create a new file here. So if I click on create new, make sure you don't put it into a public folder. I tend to put things into the root of the website. So if you put it in the public, then that potentially could expose it to hackers who might be able to access that file through the web browser. And you can give it any name you want as well. I'll call this community web as well, just so absolutely clear what we're doing here. So if I save that, and then we can save that, that SQLite file will now be created. We should now be able to go into our database manager, click on that, and we see now that we have a database available, but obviously at the moment it has no tables at all. So that's our basic setup environment for our project. Obviously we'll be looking at adding the tables and all of the other bits that are needed at a later stage, but for the moment that is as far as we're going to go in this module, and I hope to see you in our next module where we'll be looking at further aspects of Wappler.